Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. With 18 years of dribble displays and dunks with the Harlem Globetrotters under his belt, this basketball powerhouse traveled the world, wowing fans of all ages and races.
Now his playing and coaching days are behind him, but he penned a new book, and he has excelled as a public speaker and thrived as an entrepreneur. Please welcome Irv Flight Time Lang in the building. There you go.
Should I toss this? Would you catch it?
You could catch it. I hit it back to you.
I'm not gonna try.
Good. Thank you for having me.
How you doing, sir?
I'm good.
Flight Time. It's on the Sister Circle's time.
I'm here.
How about that?
Excited.
Yes, we're so happy to have you. So I understand you come from very humble beginnings, mm-hmm. Brinkley, Arkansas. Like, how did you get into sports? Did basketball find you, or did you find basketball? And actually, how did it help to change your circumstances?
Well, I mean, for me growing up, my mom, she had me at a very young age. She had six of us mm-hmm. by the time she was 26 years old.
Really?
Wow. Yeah.
Oh, my gosh, she was very busy.
Yes, she was very, she was very busy. Yes. But, I mean, she did a great job of making sure that we had everything that we needed.
Yes.
And it, for me to get to where, you know, where I am right now, it took a lot of people.
Yeah.
One of the biggest influences in my life was my high school basketball coach. He was the person that, you know, let me know that, okay, it's okay to be a great athlete, but it's more important to take care of your education. So
absolutely.
I surrounded myself with a group of guys who we all had common goals. You know, we all wanted to go to college and wanted better things for ourselves. So,
yes.
you know, it was a combination of that and just sheer determination.
I love that.
How did you become a Harlem Globetrotter, though?
The way I became a Harlem Globetrotter, so I played basketball at Centenary College located in Shreveport, Louisiana. I played there for 4 years.
Okay.
Had a pretty good career. I had an opportunity to go and participate in the college dunk contest at the Final Four in San Antonio, and I actually won.
Wow. Okay. First place?
I won the dunk contest on ESPN.
You were in first place.
Yeah, this was 20 years ago, and I definitely can't jump like I used to, but it was kind of a springboard. Mm-hmm. You know, to give me an opportunity to continue my basketball career. I actually had some opportunities to go overseas mm-hmm. after winning the dunk contest, but for me, it was more important to finish my education. I actually had a semester of school left, mm-hmm. so I went back and I student taught for a semester, worked in the gym as a personal trainer, worked the 9-to-5 and realized that, you know, I still wanted to play basketball.
Absolutely.
So once the Globetrotters got wind that I was still interested, they invited me to the training camp, and I told my boss, I said, you can hire somebody else for this position because I'm
out of here. That's awesome.
I love it.
So you became a Harlem Globetrotter when? What year was that?
It was 1999.
And starting in 1999 and where they are now, how do you think they've evolved?
Oh, I think they've evolved immensely. I mean, Globetrotters have been around for like nearly 95 mm-hmm, years. Mm-hmm. They have transcended and transformed the game of basketball around mm-hmm. the world. Like a lot mm-hmm. of the guys, especially early, like in the, I'd say the 90s, mm-hmm. some of the first American basketball players that they actually seen were the Harlem Globetrotters.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I mean,
yeah.
it's a tradition and it's a legacy. And I mean, I was blessed to be a part of it for such a long time.
Can I also add that they have now incorporated women?
Yes.
So that was an evolution within itself.
Yeah. My first 10 years, we didn't have any women on the team.
Right.
But right now, there's several women on the team. Yeah. TNT, mm-hmm. she's been there for about 10 years. She's great. And they're just continuing to bring other women in. And it's great. I mean, the little girls in the crowds, they love it. They see it as an opportunity to be able to compete with the men. Because,
yes.
I mean, in reality, women are just as athletic and just as talented
y'all
as the men
it.
Are.
I'm glad you said it. Heard it
this
from Flight Time.
I love it. So you've went all over the nations.
All over the world.
Being a Globetrotter,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes.
So what was your favorite place?
My favorite moment was, it's about 5 years ago, I had a chance to go to the Vatican.
Oh, wow.
In Rome.
Okay.
And I had a chance to spin the basketball on the Pope's finger.
No, are you serious?
Yes, I had an opportunity to do that. So it's funny too, because my dad, he's a pastor.
Okay.
And I remember when I let him know that I was gonna be going, you know, to the Vatican,
yes.
you know,
right.
to meet the Pope, and he's wondering, like, well, how did you get to,
right.
you know, make that happen?
Happened.
I mean, he just texted me, hit me up, and told me to come through. So,
did he really?
No, that didn't happen. That's not
okay,
how.
Okay, okay.
Yeah.
You played too much.
No, the Globetrotters have a great PR team, and they have connections all over the world. And during the course of Globetrotter history, they've actually made several popes honorary Globetrotters, and we just had an opportunity to go and meet
That's
Pope
really
Francis.
Cool.
And it was just nice to be there and be able to look out into the thousands of people that, mm-hmm. you know, that come every week to listen to the Pope speak, and just to be able to be a part of that was amazing.
Yeah. Well, listen, let's talk a little bit about, since we're talking about popes, okay? Mm-hmm. I mean, you have a new book here, best-selling book here. It's called Projects, Popes, and Presidents.
Yes.
Popes, because you went down to see the Vatican.
Exactly. Okay.
So tell me a little bit about what's the message that you want your readers to take away from this book?
The message that I want people to realize is that you can accomplish anything. Mm-hmm. I mean, my story is my story. My story is a little bit different from everybody else's story, but everybody's story is unique and special. You know,
absolutely.
I came from humble beginnings,
but
who would have thought that I would have a chance to travel to 90 different countries around the world, you know, meet Pope Francis, meet President Obama twice. And I want people to realize that the people that you come in contact with, it's important to develop relationships and treat people with kindness, because you never know when you're going to have to come across those people again. So everything that's happened major in my life has been as a result of the way I've treated people able to go back and, you know, keep those relationships going.
It's bigger than basketball.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's bigger than basketball.
Yes.
Well, thank you so much, Herb. You have heard it.
You gotta show us a trick.
Oh, we're gonna do a trick right now.
We gotta do a trick.
Oh, okay then. I thought we were gonna close this out.
I got these nails. I don't know what we're gonna do.
Okay, well, let's go ahead
and get over
there.
Here you go. You take that one.
Okay. Well, should I put my cards down, Herb?
Yeah, put them down.
Okay. I guess I should.
I'm gonna see what he got. Come on.
Are you gonna do what I do? Actually, you put your ball down.
Okay.
So this is what I want you to do. Okay.
Okay.
All right, I want you to take it around your body like that.
Ooh.
And off the elbow.
Oh, Lord Jesus. Now, you asking for a lot right
now.
Let's
go.
No, just let it roll. Just let it roll. There you go. Okay.
Yes.
Off the elbow. Oh, that's pretty good. That's pretty good. And you say you got those nails, right?
All
right, you hold that one.
Okay.
All right, let's hold this one up right here.
Okay.
Oh, that thing is pretty.
I know, right?
I might break it. Look at that.
Oh, my God. I'm doing it.
Yes.
You are doing it.
Much for being here. We truly
thank
do
you
appreciate you joining
me.
Us here at the Circle today. To keep up with everything amazing that this man is doing, please follow him on Instagram and Twitter at TheTrotter4. And don't forget to purchase his book, Projects, Popes, and Presidents.
Yes! I got a check.
And that's on Amazon.com. Actually, absolutely. That's on Amazon.com.